Cyber risk continues to be the greatest insurable threat to businesses of all sizes in 2021. Small businesses, including solo, single-person firms, all the way up to middle-market businesses, have seen increased threats and cyber events during the course of this year. So in this video, I'm going to give you the scoop on what is covered in the typical cyber policy in 2021. First, a bit of a disclaimer. Cyber insurance is not a standardized form of coverage, and every policy on the market will differ slightly from one another. I'll give you the broad overview of the most common features of cyber insurance today. From a 30,000 foot perspective, cyber insurance is designed to cover a wide range of expenses, costs, and lawsuits, which may arise when your company is hit with a breach, hack, or an event. But more important than just insurance coverage or money proceeds to pay for these expenses, cyber insurance will help you recover from an event by identifying and solving the cause of that event, breach, hack, or attack. The typical cyber policy is broken into three distinct sections. The first one is first-party coverages. These are coverages focused on the damages you suffer directly. The most notable today is business interruption costs you suffer while you're down from something like a ransomware attack. Other first-party damage coverages include notification costs if private data left your network and you need to notify those affected record holders, data recovery and reconstruction costs, extortion demands and other costs associated with ransomware attacks, damage to hardware, which is commonly called bricking. Number two on the list is third-party coverages. These are costs you incur from lawsuits. Legal fees, defense costs, and settlements are examples here. Other examples include networks and security privacy liability lawsuits, PCI or payment card industry fines and penalties, regulatory fines and penalties, media liability lawsuits, and I want to highlight this coverage part. In the past, the perils of libel, slander, defamation, and plagiarism were covered under most business general liability policies, unless the company was in publishing. Well, today, just about everybody is in publishing due to social media, so these claims are being denied under a general liability policy, and that's why cyber is needed, again, for these broadened exposures. Number three on the list is cybercrime, and this is where the policy form gets a little wonky and requires careful examination. This portion of the policy is intended to cover the loss of money and securities you suffer from illegal activity deploying digital as a means to commit that crime. You will see terms like social engineering, digital theft, fraudulent funds transfer, computer theft, and more in this heading. Those are the three major coverage headings found in most cyber insurance policies being sold today. Now, I mentioned earlier that in addition to insurance, which are dollars to help remediate a claim, cyber insurance policies also come with something called a breach coach, which is a specialized claims handler at the end of a cyber claims hotline staffed by most insurance companies 24/7, 365. Why do you need a breach coach? The answer is simple. When you've discovered that you've been hacked, or your data has been held hostage, or a similar event, you're going to be so wound up, you're not going to know what to do first. You need an expert to help coach you through the event so that you can recover quickly and get back to business and deal with numerous potential issues. The good news is that most insurers have breach coaches, and your call is not the first frantic call from a business owner they've experienced. They know what to do and how to do it. In my opinion, the breach coach could be one of the most valuable parts of a cyber policy. Now, what's new in 2021? Well, the last few months, we're seeing a pretty serious hardening of the marketplace. That means rising rates, more disciplined underwriting, and for firms that can't demonstrate good cybersecurity practices, a dwindling number of insurers willing to write their coverage. This is all due to the massive claims insurance companies have been covering for the past year, which really heated up since January 2021. If you have cyber insurance, it's important to read your renewal offers to see if new exclusions or conditions have been added to your policy. If you don't have cyber insurance, get it. The good news is that coverage is still available and it's affordable. There are some new entrants into the market for small business cyber, and for larger accounts, more underwriters are attracted to better accounts which have a serious data security posture. Here's the bottom line. The cyber insurance market is likely to continue to evolve through 2021 and beyond. There doesn't seem to be an end to the massive ransomware attacks taking place, and claim costs will continue to push rates higher and availability lower. That means you need to be best in class to get a great deal or a great renewal quote. Work with your managed service provider to beef up security. Take MFA seriously. Most insurers are insisting on this now. And lastly, make sure you're working with an expert when it comes to cyber insurance. Thanks for watching this video. My name is Gordon Coyle, and if you're looking for help on cyber insurance, give me a call and let's chat. No pressure, no sales gimmicks, just some conversation to see if I can help you and if we might be a good fit for your business insurance needs. I work in all 50 states, and I love solving insurance and risk problems and issues for business owners. Thanks.